When you think of Australia, one visual that likely comes to mind is a harsh landscape known as the Outback. But what if I told you that there is a stretch of wilderness just inside the Sunshine Coast that looks like a lost world from the days of dinosaurs? A temperate rainforest with flowing rivers and lush plant life, this thriving ecosystem is home to a diverse collection of animal species, and most of them have never even seen a human being. The crew and I will be heading deep into the wilds of Mullaney, where we have been granted special access to explore a private stretch of conservation land. And this location is rumored to have a flourishing population of eels. These long, cylindrical, slime-covered fish are incredibly elusive, and they stay completely hidden during the day by hiding in burrows along the river embankments. Yet under the cover of night, these stealthy predators slither out and stalk the flowing river waters, which will give us the best chance of catching one.
We're way out in the middle of nowhere, heading after our primary target tonight, the long-finned eel. My net is gonna be my best friend. That's my only chance of catching one of these animals. We're gonna move slow, take our time, and with any luck, get one of these river monsters. Here we go.
You know, all these rocks are gonna make it really hard to catch an eel.
Ankle breaker right there.
You guys holding up okay?
Honestly, these creek habitats are always kind of tough for me in terms of my footing. I did break an ankle once, and I'm always conscious of that. So when I'm walking through here, I'm very careful.
I forgot to mention that with the dangers. Spiders. Didn't realize that we're gonna be on land and in the water. Now that's a fishing spider, rather big. You can see what it's doing. It's just hanging off the side of the rock there. What it's waiting for is little fish to come up near the surface, and then it will shoot down, insert its fangs, fill it with venom, and it's got a meal. Whoa! Whoa. Look at that.
Wow. So fast.
That was crazy.
Some serious speed right there for a spider. All right, guys, keep your eyes peeled. It's not just the fishing spiders we need to look out for, but all along these embankments can also be funnel web spiders. You don't want to get bitten by one of those.
Coyote, I'm seeing a lot of shrimp in the water.
Where there are shrimp, there will be eels. That's a dead shrimp. That's exactly what these eels are feasting on. Couldn't tell you exactly how this shrimp died, but it is possible it got chomped by an eel and somehow wasn't eaten. That's a good indicator that the ecosystem is really healthy. If there's a lot of shrimp, that means a lot of things for the eels to eat. That's too bad for this little guy, but I'm just gonna place it back down in the water. Something's gonna find it, and it's gonna enjoy a free lunch.
A healthy ecosystem is everything when it comes to an eel reaching river monster proportions. As opportunistic hunters, they're without equal in terms of appetite. Not only will they feast upon shrimp, but other aquatic creatures like fish, frogs, snakes, smaller eels, and even ducks are all fair game.
There's an eel right there. Look at this.
Is there?
There's a small one, a little elver right there. It might go right through my net, he's so little.
Good practice for you.
I think it went under this rock.
Whoa, big fishing spider on the rock too.
Man, there's a lot of silt in the water. That's gonna make it super challenging. Let me see if I can coax him out. Come on, buddy, where are you?
Oh, there it is.
Jeez.
Here he is, right here on the backside. Just went right back underneath.
Back under the rock?
Yeah.
See how fast he moved? That scared me.
That's a good tactic, though. Kind of spook him out.
Yeah, I'm trying to get him to go right into the net. I think we lost him.
I think he went right underneath the rock again.
Oh, there he is, there he is.
There he is.
He's going on land. Him in that corner.
You guys can see how tricky they are to catch. Just like that. Oh man. Yeah, that's his tactic.
Right there. To the left of you.
Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy until I can get up underneath something. I think he got back up under this crevice. Yeah, there's a hole. Well, that one eluded us, but if that's any indicator as to how fast these eels move, they're like greased lightning.
We know the eels are active. We've already seen our first one.
Juvenile long-finned eels, also known as elvers, are always going to be the fastest, and their ability to quickly escape under rocks or into burrows makes them even tougher to catch. But how did they end up in this river? Long-finned eels have an interesting life cycle. They're born in the ocean, a begin life as tiny transparent newborns that barely measure 1 millimeter in length. Then over time, they travel inland through estuaries and sometimes even over dry land around man-made structures like dams to settle in bodies of fresh water. It's in this saltless environment where they are referred to as elvers, a subadult stage where they then grow half an inch every year, slowly evolving over several decades into the river monsters we now seek.
We've got an eel right down here in these tangles. I'm gonna put mine out right in front of it and tickle its tail, see if I can get it to swim right in. Man, this is a really, really, really tough spot. I'm gonna have to wedge myself in here.
I see the eel's head.
Okay, the eel's not moving. I have no maneuverability here. So it's either gonna go into the net, or we're gonna lose it. Okay, I've got the net in the best possible position I could put it in. Let me see if I can coax him out.
It's going in.
Got it, yes, woo! Yes, yes! We got an eel! It took us quite a bit of time, but we have finally got our eel. Yes, I cannot believe we got it. That was perfect, could not have worked out any better. Okay, here, let me get back out of these vine tangles here. Woo! Got one! Now this is a very delicate balance right here. I'm gonna have to work really, really gently to get it out of the net. If I lose control of it, it is going to get back into the water. But fear not, the fact that the eel's out of water is just fine right now. These creatures can spend hours out of water and oftentimes will move from body of water to body of water. So this creature is just fine at the moment. Let me bring it up as gently as I can. Look at that creature. And there it is, the long-finned eel. What a bizarre creature. I'm keeping it in the net partially so that I have control of the animal. Now the reason they're called long-finned eels, let me turn it around like this. Their tail is like a big rudder or an oar. And they have this fin that runs from about the center of their body all the way down the tail. Can you see that? This is more erect when they're underwater, and that tail gives them all their power. This is like a big, muscular water balloon. Now, these eels have incredible eyesight, especially at night. They're nocturnal predators. They'll oftentimes just lay in wait for their prey to come close to them, but they're rather nomadic. They will move from spot to spot, searching out food or finding a good place to hunker down. If you look at the shape of this eel's head, it's very flat. That allows them to easily navigate through all of the rocks. And they've got this big mouth. They actually have rows of teeth inside of that mouth. I don't want to take a bite from this creature. It's why I'm wearing gloves. And look at those little sensory organs up front on the nose. You see that? It's called tube nostrils. And they can actually sense their prey within the environment. All right, the eel seems pretty calm at this point. Let me see if I can actually bring it up slightly. Check this out. Oh, he's kind of twisting, twisting. All right, buddy, calm down there, calm down. They're just so difficult to hold onto because their bodies are completely covered in this slippery slime. I'm losing it. No! Now, like I said at the beginning, they can stay out of water for a substantial amount of time. Will actually travel from body of water to body of water if the body of water they're in dries up. You'll oftentimes find them in river or creek systems like this. They love flowing water, but you can find them in swamps and lakes as well. But how fantastic was this? Searching the river systems here in Australia and finally catching the long-finned eel.